Okay, today we're going to be demonstrating Voluma. Voluma is a hyaluronic acid filler that is FDA approved for cheekbone augmentation. And today in Kathy, we're going to augment her cheeks and also her jawline. Kathy's main, she has some topical numbing on now, which we'll remove, but her main complaint is that she wants to minimize the appearance of these folds in this area, and today I think we'll be able to achieve that by giving her a little lift in the mid-face and also smoothing out her jawline area, which will result in a lift and a de-emphasis of the lines around her mouth. So she's been sitting for 20 minutes with the topical numbing cream on, which I will remove now, and then we'll go ahead and start with the treatment. She's going to get two vials of Voluma. And Voluma lasts for about 2 years. So it's a nice filler. It doesn't wear off as quickly as some of the other fillers that are on the market. How I like to do Voluma is to start off, depending on how much the patient needs, start off with either one or two vials and add to it when we want to add some volume to the face. Meaning patient will come in for one or two vials at first, then maybe one more 6 months later, and another one 6 months after that, so that it builds up over time and the patient doesn't look drastically different from one day to the next. And then it will last for many years and it can just add to it whenever they want to have a little more volume, as opposed to getting a whole bunch of Voluma and then letting it wear off and then getting a whole bunch 2 years later. So her filler is removed, and we're going to start with the cheekbone augmentation. The goal will be to lift her mid-face, which will smooth out this line here, and we're going to fill these little hollows on the sides of her chin and smooth her jawline here. So Kathy, I'm going to have you turn your head that way, and I'm going to place my finger over your eye and lift your cheek a little bit, and we're going to start with the injection laterally. This is a nice spot because, one, it's not too uncomfortable, and it creates a nice lift to the cheek. How are you doing?
Good.
Okay.
I don't feel it well.
So it's kind of, people think it's kind of a funny sensation because you can feel it going in under the skin, but it's not especially uncomfortable at all. This is not really a sensitive area. And then we'll just massage it in here. Just a little more volume on the right side compared to the left. You can see just a little more fullness here compared to the flatness here. And if we add a little bit more, we'll create a little more of a cheekbone for Kathy. You okay?
Mm-hmm.
Finger at the top here. One, it's a little distracting to the senses, makes it a little more comfortable. And two, I want to feel the end of the needle and know where it is. That's really nice. I like that already. We used half of a vial of Voluma so far on her right side. And now I'm going to move down to her cheekbone. I'm sorry, to her chin. discussed this with Kathy before, Voluma is not FDA approved to use in, for example, the chin. But we use it in this area a lot because it creates more of a scaffold to the face. We get some volume loss in this area, which can be aging, and when we replace the volume here, it just creates a more youthful face without being too obvious, without being obvious at all. You okay? Is that a little more sensitive of an area?
Mm-hmm.
Go. Put it in, and then we just sort of step back and take a look and see how we like it. And you can see her right face is just a little more full and smooth compared to the left side. A little more lifted. I want it a little more high in her chin, so I'm going to add some more here. We can go back and add a little filler actually in her nasolabial fold, but I think we're going to see that it's a much more natural look to just replace the volume in the face than chase one line and create a more artificial look. So I am going to move to the other side. I used almost one vial on her right side, but I'll just save the rest of it. And we'll see if she needs a little more at the end on her side. Kathy, do you mind taking your right hand and just holding that gauze rightly right there? I'm usually using about the same amount on each side. Not always. We're all a little asymmetrical. Most people have a little more volume loss on the left compared to the right due to sun damage over the years. So I keep track of how much I use on each side, but I don't necessarily keep it exactly equal on each side. So we're going to do a very similar thing on the left. So Kathy hasn't taken any oral sedative or anything like that. In general, getting Voluma, it's not necessary. It's not relaxing, but it's not so uncomfortable that that's necessary. The topical numbing is usually enough. It's different than getting injections in the lips. The lips are more sensitive of an area. And sometimes more pain control is necessary. He's got this little crease, this little line here that we're going to try to fill, so I'm going to do that one first. Go straight in.
one, two. Kathy did not follow the rules and she took an ibuprofen last night. I don't recommend that people take aspirin or ibuprofen or Motrin for at least a week prior to any injections. It can increase the risk of bruising. She's not bleeding much, but bleeding or bruising after the procedure. I don't want to jinx myself and say she could get a bruise. I don't think she will. We recommend no aspirin or ibuprofen prior to any injections for a week. If people do get a bruise, we can do a laser that will treat bruising. The next day, if there's a bruise, the patient can come back in and have a laser that will reduce the appearance of the bruise.
Do you recommend arnica too?
Arnica supplements and topical arnica can reduce bruising as well. So talking about the risks of the procedure, one of the main risks is bruising. Some patients can have significant swelling after filler, not usually in the cheeks or the jawline, but that is a risk, some swelling. Very rare risks of tissue necrosis or blindness if it went into an artery. But those are all things to be aware of. Oh, she'd be pretty. So we have a little more, and some people say you can always find a place to put filler when you have a little more, and usually you can. So I'm just going to try to find where I'm going to put this little bit I have left. I'm going to put it more laterally on her cheeks just to lift them a little more. I think her nasolabial folds look absolutely great, so I'm not going to put any there. I remind people that 8-year-olds and 10-year-olds have nasolabial folds. I don't think they're a problem as long as they're in balance and proportion with the rest of your face. So I don't like to chase them and put too much filler.
I just want to look natural and pretty on my wedding day.
Yes. Yes.
Yes. I should probably say for the record, I've never done this procedure before, and from a pain perspective, it's very minimal. If you've done Botox or anything like that, it's I would say it's right in line with that.
Similar.
So nothing to be worried about.
Fillers in the lips are more sensitive, but getting the chin and cheeks is not too bad. And I'm massaging it, but I don't like the patients to massage it. You can do any activities that you want, even immediately after the filler, but I don't like people to sleep on their stomach. Try to sleep on your back for the first two nights. Because you could make it move around if you were really digging into your pillow or something. Okay. All right, that's it.
Ta-da.